Gentlemen, thanks very much for being here this morning. I know it's a busy day. I believe we're just about to go. I appreciate your time. We have asked you to come here with some important announcement to make regarding the media golf tour. First of all, I introduce the gentleman on my right, my media right, is Mr. Mohammed Juma Bonin, the chairman of the media golf tour. And on my far right, man that needs an introduction, Aaron Clark. Thank you very much. We'll hand over to Mohammed, who will announce the news.
Good morning. Thank you for being with us today, especially Aaron Clark. Thank you for being part of this setting. We will explain why he's down with us today in a minute. But I think it's nice to know how our tour developed over the past 4 years. We've started with 68 people in our first tournament in 2011. We're averaging 120. We averaged 120 for each tournament in 2014, with many people who were disappointed because we didn't have enough spaces for them. The number of Arab players have also increased. I must say, I would have been happier if we had more from the rest of the Arab world, but they only played when we went to that particular country. However, this is going to change because with our meeting on Thursday with all the Arab World Federations, it seems like they got the point after 4 years, especially because the Moroccans were winning every single tournament in the region, which is to do with the Arab World Federation. So they realized there must be something good about the media tour. We're going to stay almost with the same number of events for 2015 with the additions of a new school, because we feel it's very important. And it seems like there is an interest from the UAE Golf Federation to make the final in UAE, or the Tour Championship, slightly bigger. So they've got some plans which we're discussing with them, so it'll be a little bit more than in terms of prize fund and so on. So hopefully that will come through. There is no doubt, you know, in my mind that the MENA tour has lived up to everybody's expectation. We already have a winner, an Arab kid who won a golf tournament, which means the talent is available in this area. However, I talked a lot, and I think a lot of people get upset with me when I go on about this not being very sanctioning from the world ranking, and our friends from the European Tour, the chairman and Mr. Keith Waters, were very kind to sit down with us yesterday and calm me down a little bit and explain to me how these things work. And what came out of that meeting, actually, the world ranking aside, we should be working very, very closely with the European Tour in the future, and I hope it will be beneficial for both of us. However, we also needed to give this tour a little bit of a push, and also we needed a little bit of guidance. And we needed somebody who was a friend of ours, who's been with us for a long time, and we couldn't find anyone better than that. And he showed interest because he believes in the youth and how we could get them to play golf in the right way for a start, but also it's important that this region gets more golfers, not just get professionals. We need more golfers for our golf courses. Darren was kind enough to say that he will help in any capacity, and therefore we ask him to be our patron, which he is kindly accepted. Darren also has this school in Ireland which he started. We are very, very interested because I believe this is something we lack in this region. Yes, our schools here, they sort of run academic studies, and the kids are there from 3:30 to 4 o'clock. There's no way you're going to get any of these kids to practice golf after that, whereby these schools actually do golf and academic studies. So we'll also be interested in that. I will pass you on to Mr. Clark to tell you how he feels about this.
Well, thank you. As Mo just said, I've been coming to Dubai for a very long time, quite a lot again off late. It is one of my favourite places in the world to keep coming back to, and you know, I've always been actively involved in trying to promote golf to youngsters, especially at home where I'm from in Ireland. And when the opportunity came up and Mohammed asked me to be patron of the MENA Tour, I wasn't too glad to accept. Over my years of playing and being involved in my school at home, you know, I feel as if I've got quite a bit to offer with a young tour such as the MENA Tour. With the quality of golfers that are coming out now, that's very evident to see on the range how good the kids are getting at a younger and younger age. So the opportunities are very limited for professional golf for young kids to get into. This is an avenue, the MENA Tour is an avenue where they will get professional experience. You can practice as much as you want, but unless you perform in a tournament, that's where you find out whether you're getting better or not. And as Mo just said, there were 10 tournaments this year. I played in the Dubai Open last year, end of last year. Thoroughly enjoyed it, part of the MENA Tour. It was a great tournament on a great golf course and extremely well run. And you know, I see big things for the MENA Tour. I can only see it getting bigger and better. I think what this whole area has given to the game of golf, especially the European Tour, with us having the opportunity to come here and play in courses such as this, the Desert Class that we have, I think it's great that you know, that we're going to have a chance to give a little bit back to what they've given us as a European Tour. I think if the tour, the MENA Tour, keeps going the way that it is, I think it's a huge pathway for somebody from the region to qualify for the Olympics. That's a massive thing. We're back in the Olympics now. And without that experience, it's very difficult experience playing tournament golf. It'd be very difficult for anybody to gain experience to get into the Olympics. And this is another huge way in which the MENA Tour is going to benefit everybody in the area. As Mo said there again, you know, there's a few questions that hopefully I'll be able to answer in regarding the tournaments. Some suggestions that I will have, and also with my golf school, which I have back at home. The kids go to school in the morning. They have their lessons in the morning, and then they have the golf coaches there that take them to the gym, they coach them on the range, they do bits and pieces. So it's basically an American university sort of setup, is what the school is. But it gives them the opportunity. My school at home is from the ages of 16 to 18. So they can figure out if they're going to be good enough or not to make it in the pro ranks. So it gives them an opportunity to do their studies, yet at the same time work very, very hard on their golf. And